Now on Zoom is Jim Hotelling from Hillside Garden Landscaping, and today Jim is going to tell us about a comment that he got from a client. Jim, what did this client say to you?
Well, they're admiring the roadside wildflowers, and which is nice this time of year, you know, coming up. It is really fun to go out and drive along and see them. But then she started mentioning picking them, and it's like, all right, well and good. But as you can see by this particular picture, there's a plant on here called wild parsnip. And as pretty as it is on the wild, you don't want to pick this one, okay? It can cause a pretty bad rash.
Okay, gotcha. So is this kind of similar to poison ivy then, or?
Well, yes and no. I mean, it's very similar. It's got a juice in the plant. If you pick it, you know, and you get it on your skin, it will cause a rash similar to poison ivy. But there is one big difference. And poison ivy is called a phytotoxicity, meaning that if it just gets on your skin, it'll cause a problem, okay, with contact. With a wild parsnip, it's a phytophototoxicity, meaning that it gets on your skin, and then it gets activated by sunlight. Oh. And it's interesting to know that, because if you're out there on a cloudy day or in the morning and you're doing that and you realize, ooh, I just got into that, before you get out into the sunlight, you can wash that off and it'll help a lot.
That's but really, yeah.
And you get right out in the sun, man, it's gonna be a bad reaction.
That's really interesting that it does that. Are there different stages of growth to look out for in that plant?
Well, you know, you can see here that there's a young foliage. It's what we call basal foliage on the ground, and it's very fern-like. And there are times when the plant is young and it doesn't have the flower stalk, that's all that's there. And so it's important to be able to recognize that, and especially if you're either weeding or weed eating or something like that. Important to know that.
Okay. And I mean, you're outside a lot, I'm assuming. So have you ever been exposed to this?
Actually, yes. That's why this is near and dear to my heart, because I was actually doing some weed eating at one point, and it was just one of those things. I just picked it up very quickly, and I had fairly low socks on, and I got this rash pretty bad. So I went back up to where I was weed eating just to look around, and I saw that young lower foliage. The flowers weren't there, but that young foliage. And I'll tell you, that took me months, you know, between 3 and 6 months easily to get rid of the you know, the rash, the initial rash and stuff went away, but it was, you know, the discoloration, whatever, took months to get rid of. So it's a nasty one.
Yeah.
You'll get rid of it within, you know, a week or two, maybe. This will last and last. So be careful, people.
Definitely. It's good to know about that. Thank you so much, Jim, for sharing this with us.
You're welcome. This is Jim Hotelling, a home gardener from Hillside Garden Landscaping.
You can watch Home Gardener every week only on Around the Tiers. For today's segment and to find out more, head to WBNG.com, click on Around the Tiers, and select Home Gardener from the drop-down menu. And if you have any home gardening questions that you want answered, send them to Home Gardener.